When discussing the status of an epidemic, like COVID, everybody is talking about the reproduction number, RT. But what is this number exactly? And does it give sufficient information? What are the advantages and disadvantages? We will discuss all of this in this introductory video. So, what is the idea? The reproduction number is actually coming from population dynamics. So, what do we have? We start with the mother over here, and then she has, for example, two daughters, and both of her daughters have also two daughters. Then after two generations, we have four women, well, we started with one. So, whereas if then the mother has only one daughter, and this daughter has one daughter, then after two generations, we still have one woman in the population. So, what is the idea of this reproduction number? It tells us how many female children a woman has on average. You see, we are only talking in this population dynamics about females. Males are not so important here. They are considered to be enough men available to do their job here. So in population dynamics, we're looking at the number of women all the time. Now this reproduction number is not all of the story. You also need a so-called regeneration time. Regeneration time is the average time between generations. So the average mother age difference will be like 25 years, 30 years, something like that. We already see that this can become a bit difficult. It's not always so nicely ordered like this, because suppose you have, say, the oldest granddaughter of the oldest daughter. So we have the oldest daughter and then the oldest granddaughter. So the overall age difference like that can become sort of equal to the youngest daughter of the youngest daughter. So those generations after a while, oldest of oldest of oldest is going to mingle with the youngest of the youngest. So the generations are not so nicely structured anymore. And that will pose some big challenges later on if you are going to calculate this reproduction number. Now, moving on to epidemics. Definitions are very similar. So the RT, the reproduction number, is the average number of secondary infections caused by a single individual. So in the first picture, we start with one infected individual. He causes two secondary infections, and both secondary infections cause two tertiary infections. So you move from one infected to two to four. And an epidemic grows. And in the second picture over here, you have a reproduction number of one. So one individual infects one other and infects one other. And the number of infectees stays more or less stable. So that's what's called a reproduction number. Now, regeneration time is also very similar. That's this time difference here. It's the average time it takes one individual to infect the next. And that will depend on the epidemic, of course, will be of the order of days or weeks or something like that. Now, some small discussion. Well, this RT, this reproduction number, has some advantages, but also some big disadvantages. First of all, it's nice because it's easy to visualize. For everybody, it's clear what's happening. If your RT is bigger than one, you're going to explode because you get more and more and more infectees. So that's a clear advantage. Plus minus, well, this RT is not the whole story. It matters a lot what the regeneration time is. With a longer regeneration time and an RT bigger than one, okay, you will grow, but it will take some time before it is growing. Whereas it's a very small regeneration time, even if your RT is just above one, you can still grow very fast. So this RT is not the whole story. You also need your regeneration time. Fortunately, this is regeneration time is more or less known and more or less constant. So that's why I put a plus or minus. It's not that bad. A clear minus of the reproduction number, though, will be challenging to compute due to the fact that those generations start to mingle at a certain point. So you will have to untangle them mathematically. Okay, you can do that. It will be the subject of a few more videos. But then you get from one disadvantage to another one, because this computation is actually pretty difficult and pretty unstable in a sense. Okay, if your data are very nice and smooth, you can do the computation, but otherwise this computation is pretty difficult. So it's actually a bit dangerous to infer future behavior by looking at previous reproduction numbers. Okay, you will be able to compute your previous reproduction numbers of 1 or 2 weeks ago. However, it's varying a lot, also a bit unstable, so it's very dangerous to use it to infer future behavior. So you can use it to say something about the current status. It's a bit dangerous to look forward. So that is another clear disadvantage of using the reproduction number.